In this video, I'll show you how to build and program a baseball playing robot. You can build this robot using a LEGO Mindstorms Robot Inventor kit or the LEGO Education Spike Prime kit. This project will introduce you to the three stages of any robotic system: input, processing, and output. Input is data from the world outside the robot. In this case, the input comes through the LEGO sensors, which will detect the ball when it comes close. Processing happens inside the hub, when we take that input and do something with it. We'll create a program that runs on the hub that will tell the robot to wait for the ball and then swing the bat. Output is what the robot does as a result of the processing. Our output will be an action, the motor swinging the bat to hit the ball. We can make the robot even more fun by adding other outputs, like playing a sound effect or showing a nice animation on the hub's display. I periodically post video tutorials on building and programming LEGO robots. So why don't you subscribe by clicking the button down below, and don't forget the notification bell. And now let's program the baseball better. Let's open up the LEGO Mindstorms Robot Inventor app. Let's go to code. If we connect the robot, the device, via Bluetooth, retail connect. First, we want the motor to be fast. The default speed is 75%, so we're dragging and dropping this block here. The port is automatically set to F because the robot is connected, and we type in 100. You can find this blue block in the motor's block here in the palette at the left. We want to bring the motor in his straight position, so the bat is ready. So we add this block. The motor will go using the shortest path to position zero. Okay, and that's the setup. Now we want, whenever the ball comes close and it's detected by the color sensor, the robot to move the bat. So we go to events, we pick this hat block. The hat blocks are like hats, they stay on top of the stacks. When the color sensor connected to port D, the color is red, we want to start a sound. So we go to sound, start sound, which executes without blocking the other blocks, so the program can continue, and we add a sound from, I think it's Charlie's library, if I don't remember, I just go here and search hit, maybe all, yeah, add. Then I select, I have this sound. Then I want this block again, so I can pick another one or click duplicate and place it here. You see that the blocks snap into place when they come close to a position where they can snap in. I set this number to 40, so I want the motor to rotate to 40, and then I start the animation to celebrate the fact that we hit the ball. I go to the animation library and I pick celebrate. Ta-da! You can play it. Okay. Loop off because we want to play just once. Okay, accept. Animation celebrate. And then we want the batter to go back to zero. So I duplicate this block and add it here. Now we can download it to the robot. So let's recap what you learned. Every robotic system is based on three stages: input, processing, and output.
If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and consider supporting my work by purchasing your LEGO using the Amazon affiliate links down below. It comes without extra charge for you, but will help my channel grow. That means more juicy LEGO for everyone. Stay young, keep playing. Ciao.
Se mettessi questa frame qui così, tipo, fa cagare.